G'day, it's James here. Welcome to the channel, videos about home automation and electrical installations. I have just received this box in the mail yesterday, and within this boring brown looking box is possibly one of the best dimmers that you can get. Let's check it out and see what it's all about. Inside that brown box, there are some DALI 2 compliant rotary dimmers. And they can be part of a larger DALI system, but we're actually going to use them today just as a standalone. They don't require any controller or any programming. You just connect them up and they just work. So this is the little device just here. It's a rotary dimmer, rotary encoder style dimmer. And it has an on-off function as well. And you can see just here, we have the DALI interface that connects the rotary encoder to the DALI network. Now we can put this into a standard clipsal plate. So you can have it up to six in a plate and they snap in like so. So this is normally what you would use as a mech, but these snap in just the same. Like that. And then you can mix and match and have this whatever switches you like, push buttons or rotary encoders. They also need a power supply. So this is a 70 milliamp DALI power supply. Now I looked on the website and it looked huge. It's actually really small. So compared to a Shelly 2, you can see how small it is. And this does fit inside a standard wall box. It just needs the active and neutral connection and it connects to the DALI network and powers the network. So in other words, to make a complete network, you just need one of these, and a DALI driver of some sort to dim up and down. You can easily add more of these in a row, so you can have multi-gang switching. We're going to go back to the workshop, and we're going to plug it all together and test it out and see how we go. Okay, so what we have here is our little setup on the bench top. We've got the two DALI dimmers, one here and one here. And we've got the DALI power supply. Now that powers the DALI circuit. And we've got the mains voltage coming in over here. And that comes in and powers the power supply. And it powers this driver as well. So we've got a 60 watt 24 volt driver. And I've just got that connected up to one of the colors on this RGB strip over here. So we can test it out. Now, for a quick rundown on how DALI works, DALI is runs at about 16 volts most of the time. It doesn't have to be exactly 16 volts, but it can't have any more than 2 volts of voltage drop across the system, which limits the cable to 300 meters, which is a long way in most cases, but some commercial buildings are quite large. So you just have to make sure that the volt drop is not more than 2 volts. The DALI circuit, which is this one here, generally, it's even though it's 16 volts, it's considered as mains voltage, mains wiring, and it's often included in the same cable, in a 5-pair cable, which is okay. It works fine alongside mains cabling. It runs at a very slow baud rate. I think it's 1200 bits per second, so it's very, very slow, but it's capable of putting up with all the interference that it has to face. It can be run in a star topology, so you can split out, or it can run in a series along like this. So it doesn't matter how, or you can mix them together. And devices like this are powered by the DALI bus, whereas devices like this are powered by the mains and they're controlled by the DALI. So that's the quick rundown of it. These are DALI 2, which is also backwards compliant with DALI 1. This system here from Zen Control is designed to work as a little mini standalone system. So if you've just got one room you want to control with DALI lights, you can just plonk it in. There's no programming, there's no application controller required to keep it working properly. So it's very simple to quickly set up a small system just like the one we've got here. And it's not that expensive either. It's quite affordable. So we'll turn it on. So I've just got to plug it in and turn it on. We'll try it out. So that's powered up right now. We've got our happy face up there. So basically, a push, a tap turns it on and off, and it doesn't matter which one you use. If we rotate this down, we'll see that the light will dim down to quite a low level. And if we turn it up, it'll go up to full brightness. And we can do the same over here. So we can turn it down over here. And we can turn this one up over here. If you turn it down, and then you turn it off, if you want it to start on low, you simply turn it and it comes on. If you want it, if it's off and you press the on button, it comes to full brightness. So it pretty much does everything you need out of the box without too much any programming at all. So that's how DALI works. I've also got some of these as well that working with the system, it's just a push button. So you could obviously have 1, 2, 3, 4, however many switches you wanted, and it's just got a little indicator light in there too. Now all this stuff can be programmed to fit in with a larger system. DALI 1 has 64 addresses on a system, so 64 devices, whereas the DALI 2 is one of the things it adds is extra addresses and different addresses for input devices. There's obviously other things too, like energy management and energy readings and additional things that DALI 2 adds on top of DALI 1, but they do work in together. So that's the quick rundown of how DALI works, and potentially it would be nice if we could include it into Home Assistant, make it easy to use in Home Assistant, because standalone this is a pretty solid way of controlling your house wiring. So if anything happens to your Wi-Fi or Home Assistant goes down, you don't get poor wife acceptance factor with lights not working. This system will continue working, but when it's up and running, it'd be nice if you can control it all with Home Assistant. Now I do have a DALI to MQTT converter, which I've been playing with. It doesn't seem to be that great, but it does work. So I'm going to play with that a bit more. And I've also got another DALI Master coming on its way that I'm going to try out, and that can be controlled with an open source Python library. So perhaps I might be able to get that working with Home Assistant in some way. Anyway, that's the video I have for you today. There's just one more thing I want to try out, and that's install these dimmers in a bedroom in my house. I've got some downlights that have individual DALI drivers installed, and I'll just quickly try it there and see how that works. Yeah, so these lights here, this is Neon Flex. Now it's quite small. I think it's 11 millimeters or 8 millimeters across, and a few different brands make it, and you can't actually see the LED dots in it, so it is LED, but it looks a lot like neon. It's obviously easier to work with and probably cheaper to get. It's probably not exactly the same as neon, but it works pretty well. And this is one of the second best ones I've tried. The best one I've seen is Aqualux Neon Flex. But I'm probably gonna make another video about this stuff later, because it's pretty cool and it's very good for making features outside. And maybe another video on that later. Those LED strips are actually RGB lights as well. But enough of that, let's move on to the next part of our project here. We're going to remove the existing switch in the bedroom that's controlling the downlights, and that was connected up to the Tridonic drivers and made use of the push dim facility that's built into them. Now the same drivers also have the DALI in them, so we don't have to change the drivers, we just have to add the rotary dimmer and the power supply. And then we'll have our system up and running as a standalone system. So the power supply we're just putting that in now. And I really like using Tridonic drivers. I use them in all my projects. I really love them. They just work properly, and they're easy to install. You can see up in the corner one project I worked on, I installed some LED strip. It gave a really nice effect in the room, very subtle, very nice light. And I used a 150 watt Tridonic driver, and I connected that up as push dim. I think that having the rotary dimmers attached to a system like that will make it just that much nicer to operate and use the system. And of course the actual control equipment that we're using is not Tridonic, it's from a company called Zen Control,
which looks like it makes quite a bit of good gear, and hopefully I'll try out more of that in the future as well. Now these Tridonic drivers that are on these downlights can be programmed, so you can set the minimum level lower if it's part of a system, but because we've got a standalone system, we can't program it, so we have to be happy what the default is, which is actually quite low. And of course the beauty of using the DALI drivers and the DALI dimmers is it will work perfectly together. There won't be any flickering. You can get it down very low and everything will just work just the way it's supposed to. And it's just something that it's not possible to achieve with a cut phase dimmer. Obviously it's more expensive to have a system like this, but it just works perfectly. And we should be able to hook this in and get this work with Home Assistant too. I'd like to thank everyone for watching. And thanks for the support over the past months. And if you like this video, give us a thumbs up. And if you want to see more videos like this about home automation and electrical installations, please subscribe. Also, make sure you stay safe out there. There's lots of crazy things going on out in the world at the moment. Hope you are all keeping safe. Thanks for watching. See ya.